नमस्ते गुरुकुलियन, आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर फिट एंड फाइन एट योर होम एंड अप्लाइंग ऑल द प्रिकॉशनरी मेजर फॉर द सेफ्टी ऑफ योर फैमिली एंड योर सेल्फ ऑल्सो। टुडे अगेन वी आर हेयर, फिजिकल एजुकेशन चैप्टर थर्ड, योगा एंड लाइफ स्टाइल। इट इज़ अ प्लस टू क्लास एंड इट इज़ पार्ट 10th। इन प्रीवियस पार्ट वी कंप्लीटेड सम आसन्स। इन फर्स्ट वी कंप्लीटेड अबाउट ओबेसिटी एंड प्रिवेंटिव आसन्स ऑफ द ओबेसिटी, देन सेकेंड वन डायबिटीज आसन्स वी कैन डू फॉर द प्रिवेंशन ऑफ डायबिटीज। एंड टुडे इन डायबिटीज वन मोर आसन इज देयर, दैट इज अर्ध मत्स्येंद्र आसन। अर्ध मत्स्येंद्र आसन दैट वी कंप्लीटेड इन द ओबेसिटी प्रिवेंटिव आसन्स। सो चेक द प्रीवियस वन वीडियो और यू विल नो अबाउट द दैट अर्ध मत्स्येंद्र आसन। सो टुडे वी विल डू अबाउट अस्थमा। अस्थमा, एज यू नो, इट इज़ अ कॉमन डिजीज इन इंडिया और इन फॉरेन कंट्रीज ऑल्सो, बिकॉज ऑफ द लाइफ स्टाइल पीपल चूज। दे आर लिविंग विद स्मोकिंग, दे आर लिविंग विद सम अदर बैड हैबिट्स और समटाइम एनवायरमेंटल कंडीशंस ऑल्सो ए कॉज ऑफ अस्थमा। ओके, अस्थमा, it is a respiratory disease, means our respiratory system, saans lena, inhale exhale, lungs, relate to lungs, windpipe, bronchi. Okay, sometime what happen in the path of breathing, we can say that windpipe, bronchi or bronchiolus, there is a blockage. Because of that blockage, a person have a problem to do breathing in normal way. He face problem whenever any loaded work individual who is suffering from asthma want to do. So after some time, he feel fatigue. His breathing rate increase because blockage is there, pressure is there, the demand of oxygen is not completed by the heart or by the our lungs, that they cannot complete the level of oxygen in our blood during the workout. Or even sometime a normal thing, when we are using the stairs to go first floor, second floor, on that time also a asthmatic person face fatigue or breathing rate increased. Okay, so asthma it is allergic or non allergic disease, sometime because of mucus, sometime because of that TB, sometime because of that flu, these type of the reason behind the asthma. Okay, its cause may be genetic disorder, means vansanugat. If the problem of asthma is in the we can say parents or grandparents, so automatically sometime it's happen the child which take birth from the person who is suffering from asthma, automatically it transfer to their child. Third one, somewhere environmental factor also. Behind the asthma, people used to do work in type of environment where that pollution level is high, or nowadays it's a common thing like shahrikaran, you can say urbanization is going on, or in urban areas what happened, there is a load of traffic, there is a load of work in factories, or the releasing pollution by the factories more than the rural area in the urban area. Because of that, we found lots of people suffering from the asthma in urban areas. Or some people, they used to do work in the factory where the level of pollution, the level of dust is very high. We can say any factory, we can say any cellar where that we can say rice mills, there the problem they will face in the future, not we can say in the present time, but sometime after 2, 5, 3, 5, 10 years they face the problem of asthma after the completion of 5, 10 years in the area where level of pollution is high. Or sometime it's caused because of that pneumonia, we can say mucus, flu, TB, these type of things are also the responsible for the asthma. Okay. So some asanas are there. Some asanas we can do for the prevention of asthma, or the person who is having asthma, they can also do these asanas for the improvement in their health or asthmatic situation. So first preventive asan for the asthma is Sukhasan. It is known as the ease pose, pleasant pose. These are the other name of this Sukhasan. Sukh means we can say pleasure, where we feel happy. Asanas means posture, attaining the pose. It is the Sukhasan. Ease pose, pleasant pose, these are the name of this asana. Decent pose also. So procedure of Sukhasan. In simply Sukhasan, like in Hindi we can say plathi maar ke baith jana, it is known as the Sukhasan. Only some things we have to concentrate, that our back should be straight, our shoulders should be relaxed, but that back should be straight, okay. Or the position of legs, it should be like the triangle shape. Procedure first, sit with straight legs. Second one, fold your legs normally, like fold your leg, that one feet will go under the left hip, or second another feet will go under the right hip, okay. Back, should be straight. We have to keep our hand. Keep your hand on your knees. One thing is there to strengthening the arms, or वी कैन डू वाइल वी आर डूइंग दिस आसन व्हेन वी आर सिटिंग इन सुखासन. अप्लाई योर हैंड्स लेटरल साइड मीन्स नियर योर हिप और दैट प्रेस योर पाम्स टूवर्ड द सरफेस फ्लोर. सो ऑटोमेटिकली इट्स पुट अप योर बॉडी इन द एयर और मे बी सम पार्ट ऑफ योर हिप विल टच द सर्फेस. मीन्स प्रेशर विल गो नॉट गो ऑन योर हिप्स. मीन्स यू विल नॉट सिट ऑन द सर्फेस विद टचिंग हिप्स. योर प्रेशर विल बी ऑन द पाम्स. मोर देन 90% लोड ऑफ योर बॉडी विल गो ऑन पाम्स. और इफ यू आर प्रोफेशनल वन यू कैन पुट अप योर फुल बॉडी एक्सेप्ट योर पाम्स. सो 100% body weight will go on the palms. Okay, this thing also we can do or easily we can come back from this position. Or then we will keep our hand on our knee or then maintain this position for some time because it is a sukhasana. Anybody can do. If a person is not suffering from obesity, the person is having a lean body mass, the person is fit and fine, means mesomorph, ectomorph, so they can perform this asana easily. Only some problem the person who is having obesity he will face while or during this asana. Benefits of this asana. It's relax our nervous system and ease our respiration. Strength of back increase while we are performing this asana. It's helpful in asthma because passages of breathing open, like any type of blockage is there in respiratory. So if we are doing this asana, automatically these bones become in relaxed mode, that our sternum or clavicle bones, mainly this sternum bone, or if any type of blockage which is cause of that pressure or any type of disability in sternum, so it's slowly improve the condition of the blockage. Means improve means not that blockage will become worst, means it will decrease the level of blockage or automatically our breathing rate or breathing process become easy or normal. Okay, and for nervous system 2-3 thing is there. It's calm our mind, free from stress, and it's helpful to prevent from anxiety or anxiety. Okay, contraindication. person who is suffering from knee pain or back pain. They have to avoid this asana. Second one, if anybody feel discomfort during this asana, so because it is known as the Sukhasana, means simplest asana in the yoga. Second simple asana, first one is Savasana. Simple asana in yoga, if anybody feeling discomfort during this asana also, that they have to consult with the doctor, or where they have facing the problem during this asana, like knee problem, back problem, or any other problem they are facing, so they have to consult with the doctor. Third one, if a person have problem in, we can say, abdominal area, they have to perform this asana with trainer or suggestion of the trainer. Firstly, if we are a beginner one, then we have to take advice from the trainer, or then we have to perform this type of asanas. Without advice or without trainer, we can say command, if we doing asanas, we don't know the benefits of asana, we don't know the contraindication of asana, we don't know the process of asana, so somewhere we found wrong during the performing of the asana, or it will not give the benefit, that one benefit which is the real one we are getting from the asana, something we did wrong, or it bring the any major injury in our body, but not on in Sukhasana or Savasana. These are the simplest asana in the yoga. Next one is Chakrasana. Chakra means wheel, asana means posture or pose. It is known as the Chakrasana. One more name is there, Urdhva. Dhanurasana, we know that we have to do in prone position, we have to lay down in Bhujangasana, then we will touch our or carry our legs, or we have to stretch it up, or that position become a Dhanurasana, but it is the opposite side of that Dhanurasana, so it is Urdhva Dhanurasana, opposite direction of the Dhanu. Urdhva means uthna, upar uthna, okay, upward. This asana we can see in gymnastic. Mostly this pose we see in the gymnastic because they have to perform different type of stretchable position, or ऊर्ध्व धनुरासन और चक्रासन, दिस टाइप ऑफ पोजिशन वी सी इन द जिम्नास्टिक. नाउ वट इज द प्रोसीजर ऑफ धनुरासन, सॉरी चक्रासन. प्रोसीजर ऑफ चक्रासन, एट फर्स्ट वी हैव टू ले डाउन इन सुपाइन पोजिशन. सुपाइन पोजिशन इट इज नोन एज द लाइक आवर फेस अप टू द स्काई. ओके, सुपाइन अप टू द स्काई, प्रोन पोजिशन डाउनवर्ड टूवर्ड द ग्राउंड. सो सुपाइन पोजिशन. सेकेंड वन, फोल्ड योर limbs alternate, yeah, alternate fold your limbs, anything we can use. Means at first lay down in supine position like savasan, then fold your limbs alternate. Means at first fold your leg or that your heel, we can say your feet, you will place near your hip both feet, or then here limbs we can say legs or arms. Third ones, keep your hand near your head or ear or shoulder also we can say here. Okay, fourth one, press your palm and feet toward ground. When we press our palms of hand or feet toward the ground, automatically it push our body upward, upward. Okay, suppose I place my hand or that feet here, so it is the position. When I press this hand, so automatically it give the this position of to our body. So press your palms and feet toward the ground. Put up your rest of body in, we can say rainbow. Body like rainbow, like this. Okay, curve we see in the pose. Even we can say bridge also, you know our bridges are like this, so bridge pose also we can say to this asan. So it is the procedure of chakrasan. Depend on your capacity, if you have a professional one then you can do this asan for long duration like 1 minute, 2 minute, or if you have a beginner one then 15 to 30 second in the beginning you have to maintain for 7 to 15 days. Automatically after some time practice you become perfect, or duration of this asan also increase. Okay, so it is the procedure. Some time of little diagram, small diagram which are relating to this asan you can give in the answer whenever you are asked by the examiner in the exam. Okay, benefit of this asan. बेनिफिट ऑफ दिस आसन, इट्स इंक्रीज स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ आर्म्स. सेकेंड वन, आर्म्स एंड लेग्स. इट्स इंक्रीज द फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी ऑफ बैक, बैक और स्पाइन. इट्स स्ट्रेच आवर चेस्ट और शोल्डर ब्लेड. ब्लेड हेयर नोन एज द स्कैपुला, द बोन फ्रॉम बैक. हेयर वी कैन सी वेन एवर यू आर वॉकिंग, ए बोन इज देयर विच इज लिटिल बिट कम आउट फ्रॉम आवर बैक आउटसाइड. So that is known as the shoulder blade or chest. During this asana, pressure is there on our chest. If pressure is on there, our chest automatically it relate with our lungs. So pressure is there on lungs. If any type of blockage is there in our lungs, so through this asana we can remove these type of the blockage from the respiratory system. Or important thing is there during this asana, it's stimulate the thyroid and pituitary gland. Both are the very important gland in our body. Pituitary gland is known as the master gland because it control the other endocrine glands. Or second one, thyroid gland, it is also responsible for our growth. Responsible, it secrete the thyroxine in our body which maintain the level of urea, or we can say iodine. Sometime what happen, a disorder or a disease, we can say when level of iodine is not in appropriate way in our body, we face the problem of goiter, galgand, genga, that swelling in our neck. So thyroid or pituitary gland. What happen whenever we are doing these type of asana, we can say Shirsasana, we can say Sarvangasana, we can say Halasana. On that time, the blood circulation of the body, the flow of the blood toward the head during Shirsasana, during Chakrasana, during Halasana, during Sarvangasana. So the pressure of blood toward the head, so thyroid gland is there or pituitary gland, we know in the base of our skull, that downward from our brain under the thalamus. Okay, so pressure is there, so automatically these glands stimulate or they secrete the hormone, which hormones are very important for our growth and for the control on other glands also. Contraindications. Those have heart problem, blood pressure, any type of syndrome in back or spine, they have to avoid this asana. Any type of surgery in past time, in abdominal or back, they have to avoid this asan. These are the contraindication of this asan. Or one more, in every asans, pregnant lady, in all asan we can say that pregnant lady have to avoid this asan, especially except that savasan, we can say savasan. Okay, so these are the contraindication of this asan. Next one is Gomukhasan and then Parvatasan. Gomukhasan and Parvatasan we will do in another part. For today this much. Thank you.